Ladies and gentlemen, the young man to my left is a Grammy Award-winning producer who's from LA, but his music is played and heard globally. This is Hit Boy. Fam. Welcome to Cabbie Presents.
Fam, we finally made it happen.
I know, it's been a while.
I should probably sign a Hit Boy, cause I got all the hits, boy.
I don't know how often you get to go to games. You said you go to a Clippers game sometimes.
Clippers games, a couple
Lakers
times.
Games sometimes. Arenas is where pop music goes to die. Like, you'll sit in an arena and you'll hear a song from like 20 years ago. Mm-hmm. I'm like, they're still playing this freaking song? If you're at an arena and it's, say, it's 2034, how are you gonna feel about it, you think?
Man, I guess we'll have to wait to see.
I know, but like, if you're like, would you be like, man, I can't believe like this song is like now, man, it's ended up here. It's in this graveyard.
I'm gonna be happy. I'm gonna be super happy.
Produced Drake's Trophies, which has a huge sound. Those horns are very big. It sounds like it was written for LeBron James' third NBA championship. Like, it's like the announcement. It's the pronouncement of the king. That's how it feels.
I think
like
that kind of just means that it is meant for champions.
Where did those horns come from?
Those horns actually came from like a cowboy sample I found. If I played you the sample, it would mess your mind up. But it's just like I just chopped it and made it make sense for those drums. Yeah.
Sick. What athletes have like reached out to you via text or social media? Be like, I love the music that you're like a specific song or a project.
Definitely my man Kevin Durant, he shows a lot of love, you know what I'm saying? Like he told me he messed with grinding my whole life. My man Arian Foster,
you know
what I'm saying, from the Texans, he's super HS87 supporter. So man, I got some, you know, people showing love.
What are your thoughts on athletes as MCs?
You know what?
Because Kevin rhymes.
Right, I'm already knowing. That's the homie.
A young boy, but I'm living old. Your boy young, but I'm living with a different soul. Space on the left side of my chest, and it's feeling cold. Same destination to my goal, but on a different road.
If it's good, it's good. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't care who you are, what you do. Kevin might have been writing raps in seventh grade. I don't know that, you feel me? So, but if he can do it well, then it's cool.
I should probably sign a Hit Boy, because I got all the hits, boy.
Hit Boy, you're an L.A. dude.
I am.
Your real name is Chauncey. Okay. Now, in the 2004 NBA Finals, when the Detroit Pistons beat your LA Lakers, were you upset but also quietly happy that a guy named Chauncey was the MVP?
Man, most definitely. Like,
there aren't a lot of
Chaunceys. I always got love for people named Chauncey. Shout out to Chauncey Black from Black Street, too.
Right,
you
know, yes,
that's
yes.
That's another Chauncey I grew up. Okay, yeah, I got hope, you know what I'm saying? But nah, man, I definitely was kind of like hot, you know, that the Lakers lost. As always.
Your team's in shambles right now. Have you ever met Kobe?
I actually met him after the first Watch the Throne concert in LA. Went backstage and chopped it up with him, you feel me? And the first thing he said to me was like, that's cool, but what's next? I like that they just performed your song like 11 times, but what's next? And you know, Kobe inspired me to go harder.
Ninjas in Paris. What does Kanye say at the beginning of the record?
Ball so hard, wanna find me.
Where did you find the synth where it goes ding, ding? Bing, bing,
man, just
bing,
bing, digging through bing, sounds, bing, bing. Digging through sounds, and just found that, and it was
weird. Like, what is that?
Like, just some synth I found, just like randomly, like.
Because it's so iconic. Ninjas in Paris earned you a Grammy Award as a producer. I interviewed Michael Jordan, and I brought up that song to Michael Jordan. When you heard the Jay-Z song, the Paris song, when he starts listing the other Michaels, Jackson, Tyson, Jordan, Game 6. When you started hearing the Michaels, were you like, my name better be in this line?
No, I was surprised my name was, but I was happy about it too, though.
And then I interviewed Mike Tyson at his house.
Biggie's really the inventor of that saying.
Wrong nights, I perform like Mike. Come on. Anyone, Tyson, Jordan, Jackson, action.
So telling you this now, that Michael Jordan and Mike Tyson have heard your song. How do you process that? These guys are icons,
man,
for the world.
I'm gonna tell you, man, like, I'm just appreciative of, you know, any type of progress, anybody liking my music. Like, I just used to like randoms just to like my music. So like for people like icons, like, you know, Michael Jordan, like Mike Tyson, like Kobe Bryant, like all these people to like something that I was a part of, man, it just influenced to go harder and really like make this thing a reality.
It's been wonderful speaking with you, man.
That means a lot, bro.
And in the future, can I call you Chauncey?
Man, you can do that, bro.
Awesome.
Fan.
Great to meet you.